Hello and welcome to our experimenting with chocolate activity. In this activity we'll look at how chocolate can change when we heat and cool it, and we'll learn about a concept called polymorphism, which will help us to understand why chocolate can sometimes lose its snap. So let's get started. For this activity you'll need a piece of chocolate, a plate, a notepad and pen to note down observations, and we'll need somewhere warm and somewhere cold to put our chocolate. If you want to follow along with this video, the recipe card on our website lists everything you need, full instructions and all the health and safety advice. So step one, let's break our bar of chocolate in half and note the sound produced when the bar breaks. Let's take a closer look at the edge of the broken piece and note down what the broken edge looks like. On this chocolate you can see the break is fairly smooth and it hasn't crumbled. Step two, we're now going to melt our chocolate. So take one half of the chocolate and place it on a plate and put that plate on a radiator or in the sunshine. If you want to melt the chocolate using a heating element instead, make sure you ask an adult to help. Depending on how we decide to melt the chocolate, it can take a few minutes to a few hours to do so, and like a lot of scientific experiments, patience is key. As you start to see the chocolate melt, it should change shape. This piece of chocolate was melted in front of a space heater set at 41 degrees for 20 minutes. Step 3. Once your chocolate has melted, the next step is to make it a solid again. We could leave it somewhere cool, like a table, away from any heat, but this will take time, so what we're going to do is put our piece of chocolate in the fridge. You might want to check on your chocolate every 30 minutes and note down the changes in appearance as it starts to become a solid again. Step 4. Once the chocolate has become solid again, take it out of the fridge and place it next to our piece that was not melted. We are now going to note down the differences between our two pieces of chocolate. If we were to try to break this piece of chocolate now, we'd probably still be able to hear a snap, but it wouldn't be a fair test. So what we're going to do is allow the cold chocolate to warm back up to room temperature. Once the melted chocolate is no longer cold to touch, break the piece and note any changes in sound compared to the unmelted piece. How easy or hard was this piece to break compared to the unmelted piece? Now let's look at the edge where we broke the chocolate. We can see the break isn't as smooth and the change in texture is visible. It may also feel more crumbly, like we can see here. After our hard work and patience, it's now time to enjoy some chocolate. You can taste the melted and unmelted piece. The chocolate should still taste the same because the molecules inside the chocolate are the same, but it may feel different on our tongue because we have transformed the chocolate from one polymorph to another. So what is polymorphism? Let us imagine we have a crystal made up of smaller molecules A and B. If molecules A and B can be arranged in different repeating patterns inside our crystal, this is called polymorphism. And although the crystals contain the same molecules, the different arrangements of these molecules can mean the crystals have different properties. Chocolate is a compound that exhibits polymorphism because cocoa butter molecules can arrange themselves in at least 6 different ways in a crystal. Heating the chocolate causes the molecules inside the chocolate bar to move around, changing it from a solid to a liquid when the chocolate melted. When we cooled the chocolate down again, the molecules stopped moving around and the chocolate re-solidified. How the cocoa molecules pack together when it re-solidifies can cause some physical observations that can signify a new polymorph has formed, such as a change in colour and appearance. If you did notice a difference in your chocolate, then you have probably made a different polymorph and the cocoa butter molecules are packed together in a different arrangement. We learned earlier that there are at least 6 different ways cocoa butter molecules can arrange themselves. So you could try to heat your chocolate up or cool the chocolate down at different rates to see what happens and see if you observe any different properties. To do this, why not repeat the experiment, but this time try putting your chocolate in the freezer instead of the fridge and see if you spot any differences. We hope you've enjoyed experimenting with chocolate. Why not try one of our other activities to continue your adventures with crystals?